tutorial on a normal actually, it's a tutorial on a normal probability plot, creating one with a TI-83 plus or similar. And so the idea with the normal probability plot is if you just have data, so I have some data here, a bunch of numbers, and I'm curious if this data came from a distribution that's approximately normal, what I can do is I can create a normal probability plot using all of this data and then take a look at it, and based on how it looks, I can draw the conclusion of whether, yeah, it looks like it came from a distribution that's approximately normal, or no, it looks like it did not. So what I'm going to do in this example is I went back and I looked at the points per game that Kevin Durant scored in the 2012 playoffs, and I recorded those all here. Against the Mavericks, he had 25, then 26, then 31, then 24. This was in the series against the Lakers, Spurs, and then Miami. Doesn't matter who he scored them against at all. I just wrote that down so I could keep track of them. So I have all these observations, and what I want to do is create a normal probability plot and then draw a conclusion. So the first step is to enter all this data into your calculator. I already did that. If you go under Stat and Edit, you can see in L1 I have all this data. So maybe I'll say Step 1, Enter Data into a list. I have a separate video on how to enter the data into lists, so I'll go ahead and assume you can do that and move on. Step 2 is program. We want to program our normal probability plot. And the way you do that is you go under stat plots here. So if you hit second and then y equals, so this is under stat plot, which on this calculator was second and then y equals. And then hit enter, it's the sixth type. So make sure it's on, and then if you go down to type here, this first type is scatter plots, here's some histograms, here was our box plot. This sixth type here is what we use for normal probability plots. And then under the sixth type, we want our data list to be wherever you put your data, so maybe data list is whatever you used up here, and your data axis, what it's asking here is which axis, your x-axis or your y-axis, should I plot the actual values on, and we want to use the x. So let's see, my data is in L1. So I'll hit second and then one to get L1 to pop up, and then x-axis. Mark, you can use whatever you want. That's just how it's going to show up on your normal probability plot. And then maybe step 3 is view. View your normal probability plot. And the way you do that is, well, one way to do that is zoom stat. Zoom stat. What I mean by that is if you hit this zoom key up here, and then the ninth thing on the list, or on my list, says zoom stat. If I hit enter, there's my normal probability plot. Maybe step 4 is to analyze. And that's not spelled right. And that's still, I don't know how to spell analyze. Analyze. I'm going to leave it how it was because I don't know how to spell. Analyze. So analyze this thing right here. Okay, so the way you analyze is there's kind of two different cases. So case 1. Is if you don't have what are called bands, which is in the case of a TI-83 plus. So what I'm saying is if your normal probability plot just looks like this, there's no bands, and I'll tell you what bands are in just a minute, then what you have to do is if data is approximately linear. Then it comes from a distribution. It's very hard to write without seeing the cursor. It comes from a distribution that is approximately normal. So what do I mean by that? Well, what your calculator does here is on the y-axis, it kind of picks where each observation should be. So if this data right here came from a distribution that was perfectly normal, it can kind of predict where these values should be. Most should be in the middle, but some are, they'll be kind of symmetric above and below. How far above and below? Well, it can look at the mean and standard deviation and kind of make those predictions on what these values should be. So that's what it's doing on the y-axis, and on the x-axis, it's just plotting each data point. So this right here was our smallest observation. It ended up being right here on my x-axis, and on the y-axis is kind of where the calculator said it should be. The second one, x-axis is where it was, y-axis is where it should be, and so forth. So if all these data points lie exactly in a straight line, then that means they're all exactly where they should be. In other words, the data looks like it came from something that's normal. So the question is, we don't have a straight line here, but we have something that's roughly linear. Is that linear enough? In this case, I'd say, yeah, that's linear enough. I mean, it's not perfectly linear, but it's got a pretty good trend here. So if data is approximately linear, then it comes from a distribution that is approximately normal. So in this case, conclude that Kevin Durant's points per game come from a distribution that is approximately normal. So if you're making these on a calculator, that's all you can do. You have to look at this thing, and it's kind of a subjective call, kind of a ballpark call. Note these will always be increasing because on the x-axis we kind of order them, on the y-axis we order them. So we'll always have some sort of, these points will never decrease at all. You'll always have some sense of linearity, but the question is how close to a straight line are they? And it's really just subjective. I think in this case they're close enough to a straight line where we conclude that it did come from an approximately normal distribution. To get rid of that subjectivity, often when these are made, they'll have bands with them. What do I mean by bands? Well, let me give you an example. We have all our data points, so you know, maybe it looks something like this. Well, sure, that's good enough. Maybe those are our observations, but instead of just having this as our normal probability plot, if there's bands included, we'll get something that looks like this with it. We'll get these lines that kind of have this, what, concave shape or convex, depending on which side of it you're looking at. And if there's bands, the conclusion is a lot easier. They kind of tell you whether the data is approximately normal or not. Or approximately linear, and therefore the distribution's approximately normal. What do I mean by that? If all observations are inside the bands, then data is approximately, then data is approximately linear. So what they use as the cutoffs for these points falling in a straight line are these green bands. If we had a dot outside of these green bands, we would say it's not linear, but in this case they're all inside, so we say it is linear. And if our data is approximately linear, then our data comes from a distribution that's approximately normal. So basically what happens with these is if you're making them yourself, all the TI can give us is something like this. It won't include the bands for you. So it's kind of subjective. You have to make a judgment call. But a lot of statistical software will put the bands in here, and you can create the bands by telling it how sure you need to be of your conclusion, what level of confidence you have. But that's not something we'll do in our class. In our class, either you'll be given the bands or you'll create your own. If you create your own, it's just a ballpark, a subjective call. If you're given one that has bands in it, you look at the bands and say, all right, if all the dots are inside the bands, my data is approximately linear. If there's a dot outside of the bands, my data is not linear. And if your data in this normal probability plot is linear, then it comes from a distribution that's approximately normal. If it's not linear, then it doesn't come from a distribution that's approximately normal. So I think that's everything you need to know about normal probability plots and how you create one with the TI. So that's the end of this tutorial.